Hi everyone. Today we are again with the chapter number 4, quadratic question with. Already we have discussed about whatever the standard form of a quadratic question, and then after that we are going to discuss its solution method there, in which we have already discussed solve by factorization method. Here we are again with some examples to solve it by using factorization method there. One of the problem what we have to solve for x, and the quadratic question is given as abx square plus b square minus acx minus bc equal to 0. We have to be factorize it. Then what do we do in solution? What are we going to do? That abx square plus b square x minus acx minus bc equal to 0. Now we are going to form a pair of this ones. This is the first pair, this is second pair. Which is what is common, the fact between that? What we see that here is common is what? Bx, and what we have? We have Ax, and here is B. In this pair, what is common that? What we see that this we have the common C there, minus C there. Taking minus C common there, then we have Ax plus B equal to 0. Now we take Ax plus B as common, then we take Ax plus B as common, then we have Bx minus C equal to 0. Now again we have A into B equal to 0, the numbers spread up to real numbers are 0. It's happen only when either this 0 or this 0. Then when Ax plus B equal to 0, this gives x equal to minus B by A. When Bx minus C equal to 0, this gives x equal to c by b. Hence, the required solutions are, hence we have the required solutions are x equal to minus b by a and x equal to c by b. We are going to solve it by using factorization method there. One of the second problem is what we have. We have to solve by factorization method. Find the roots of quadratic equation root 2x square plus 7x plus 5 root 2 equal to 0. We have to solve it by factorization method. What we do in factorization method? We first of all going to multiply with this 5 root 2 into root 2. What we gave in our last classes, we discussed that we are going to multiply with the coefficient of x square and constant term. This we get 10 here. Then we are going to find out the factors of 10 such that this is our positive sign. The factor of 10 such that its sum equal to b. Here b is our 7. Then we have two factors, 5 and 2. Which product are 5 into 2? Which product are 10? And whose sum are 7 there? Then we are going to be a split middle term. Now we have root 2x square plus 5x plus 2x plus 5 root 2 equal to 0. We are going to split middle term here. Now taking pairs of this, when we are going to take pairs, just here this common is x, then we have root 2x plus 5. In this pair, this is what is common there, this is 2. 2 means root 2 into root 2. Then we take root 2 common there, then we have root 2x plus 5. Now taking the root 2x plus 5 common there, root 2x plus 5, x plus root 2 equal to 0. Now we have two multiplication of two real numbers are the 0, but both cannot be simultaneously 0, then we have take one of them the 0. When under root 2x plus 5 equal to 0, then this gives x equal to minus 5 by root 2. When x plus root 2 equal to 0, this gives x equal to minus root 2. These are the solutions of the given equation. Till now we have discussed about the solution of quadratic equations by using factorization method there. Now we are going to discuss one of the method what we have to follow it. Now we are going to discuss one of the another method there to find out. So to the exemption point of view, this is not very important that, but on the basis of knowledge point of view, you have to be take the knowledge about the solution method of this. Then let's go with some examples there. Just take a consider one of the examples. Let us consider one of the example. Let us consider we have the one of this example. X square plus 12x plus 20. We are going to be 20 equal to 0. We are going to be solve it. We have the one of the example. X square plus 12x plus 20 equal to 0. Now let's just see. This can be written as, here we are going to just take a look, x square plus 2 into 12x by 2. We are going to write down this, we multiply with 2 and divided by 2, the given equations, and shifting 20 equal to right hand side. Now what we see that we multiply with 2 and divided by 2, then again what we going to do, divided by 2, x square plus 2, it's a 6x equal to minus 20. Then we are going to do that 2 into, we have 6x, we are going to adding plus 36, and we are going to add it plus 36 on the both sides there. Now what we see that it's a x plus 6 whole square, and here we have 16 there. X plus 6 whole square equal to, this is the whole square up plus minus 4. Then we have x plus 6 equal to 4, or x plus 6 equal to minus 4. When you're going to take the square root of both sides, then we have, when this is x plus 6 equal to 4, then we have x equal to minus 2. When we have x plus 6 equal to minus 4, then we have x equal to minus 10. Then we have the solution x equal to minus 4 and minus 10 for the this equation. We observed that in the above process, the term containing x is completely inside a square, and the solution is found by taking square root of both sides. This method of a solution or solving a procedure is known as quadratic equation, is known as by this procedure is known as by completing square method. And we are going to be solve the problems with one of the method, completing square method. What do you have to do in the method in the completing square method? Just suppose in a simple way I am going to explain that. In a completing square method, just we have ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. We have one of the quadratic equation there. To solve by completing square method, just remind that we are going to be adding b by 2a whole square on both sides. To simply using completing square method, what we do, first of all go to write the format there, comparing the values of abc, find the values of abc there, and go to adding b by 2a whole square on the both side, and make complete square, and then solve it. Now I am going to be discuss this of the solution way by one of the example there. Just take up one of the example. Solve x square minus 9x plus 18 equal to 0 by completing square. By completing the square method, we are going to solve this problem by completing square method. What we said, well, first of all, we are going to compare with ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. We get the value of a is what, 1, b is equal to minus 9, and c equal to 18. What we say that we have to adding the values of b by 2a whole square on the both side, then go to find out the values of b upon 2a. What we have b upon 2a? Minus 9. And 2a is what? A is 1. 2a is what? 2. And we are going to be add the values of b by 2a whole square. Means we are going to add minus 9 by 2 whole square on the both sides of the given equation there. Then we have x square minus 9x plus 18 equal to 0. First of all, x is write down x square minus 9x equal to minus 18. Shift the constant terms to the first of all, we have to be shifting the constant terms to the right hand side. Then we are going to adding the values of b by 2a whole square on the both side. Now we are going to add x square minus 9x plus we are going to add minus 9 by 2 whole square on the both side. What do we see there? This is the a square plus b square and we have a minus 2ab there. A square plus b square minus 2ab there. Then this is the a plus a minus b whole square. Then we have x minus 9 by 2 whole square. We get the complete square there. And whenever we are going to solving this, what we have? This is 81 by 4. And minus 18. When we are going to solve it, we have 81 minus 18 4 is 72. Taking its solution, we get here is a it's b equal to it's b equal to 9 by 4 in the whole square. It's b write down 3 by 2 plus minus 3 by 2 whole square. Now we have both sides are squared. Then we are going to taking the square root of both side. When we are going to taking the square root of both side, taking square roots of both sides, we have what we have. First of all, x minus 9 by 2 is equal to we take positive values there. 3 by 2. When x equal to x minus 9 by 2 equal to 3 by 2, what we get there? We get x equal to 9 plus 3, 12 by 2. We get x equal to 6 there. When x minus 9 by 2 equal to minus, taking the negative sign, minus 3 by 2, then when we go to shifting there, this is 6 by 2 positive there, 6 minus 3. X equal to 6 minus 3. Sorry, 9 minus 3, 6, 6 by 2 equal to 3. We get x equal to 3 there. Then we are going to find out the values of x square minus 9x plus 18 equal to 0 by computing square method. What do we do? First of all, we are going to compare the values of a, b, c there. Then we get a equal to 1, b equal to minus 9, c equal to 18. And write down the equation. Shift in the constant terms to the right hand side, x square minus 9x equal to minus 18, and getting the value of b upon 2a, what we get equal to minus 9 by 2, taking the square of this. When we are taking the square of this, we are going to add on the both sides of the values of b by 2a whole square, making the left hand side completing square, solving our right hand side, making both sides perfect square there, then taking the square root of both side and going to solve, we get the values of variable there. This is the method is known as completing square method.